I'm Swiggin Steve. I'm your supermarket beer, supermarket bargain beer reviewer. It's been a while since I last did a beer review, but here we go. So let's have a look in my domain. So we're gonna start. I'm gonna try and do a series. Never done a series before because I get too bored quickly. But I'm gonna try and do a Black Sheep. Look at this, Black Sheep box set. We'll have a look at that book. There we go. Six beers in there. All together, I'm gonna try and do them all. That's my goal. I'll try and do them consecutively. So thank you, Matt Briggs. Shout out to Matt Briggs for that. One of my ex-students, obviously knows what I like. He's given me this as a little bit of a present. So there we go. Thank you very much for that. I don't know what this retailed at because it was a present. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to review the beers at supermarket price as what they are as individual beers. So what I'll say £1.50 per bottle, just to make it easier. And look at this. Look at that. What's this? Look at this. This is Australian lager, craft lager. Look at that. That came in at Shafton in my little cost cutter place. 50p a bottle. So I got 12 of them for £5.99. Look at that. Now that is what I call a bargain. As you can see behind me there, collecting some Wold top beers that my dad got me for my birthday. He's been up to Humanby in the North Yorkshire to pick some of those up. So, without much further ado, I'm going to try and get on with this beer review. That rhymes, doesn't it? My point, and I didn't know it. I'm just going to pause it for 1 second and unpause. So here we go. I've just took the top off there, and we're starting off today. Let's start with the flagship beer, shall we? Black Sheep Ale. All right. Quintessentially British beer. And on. Just off the smoke there, getting that lovely breadiness that you get from these sort of real ales, traditional Black Sheep. Black Sheep for me, as far as cask ales are concerned, they're always reliable, they're always brilliant. They're just kind of what you want. I always associate it with going walking, going out hiking, going to a country pub somewhere. That's what I associate these beers with. So let's pour it in and see what it looks like. One-handed, so it might have a bit of a head on it. So, I've got sort of a tan coloured head, a huge head, because I've poured it in one-handed without tipping my glass. That's not how you're supposed to do it, but there we go. Fortunately, when I'm holding my camera like that, there's not much I can do about it. And even on the carbonation, even though there's loads of carbonation on that beer, I'm still getting a really strong maltiness coming through, a really characteristic maltiness. Not just a maltiness that you get from a cheap beer from your supermarket, but something that's got a little bit of character. It's got a lovely sweetness. It's got a breadiness. It's got a little bit of a nuttiness to it. And there's a citrusness coming through. There's a citrusy hop coming through there. There's a little bit of lemon zest. And that's what I like. It's not just a malt forward beer. There is a citrusy hoppiness to this. And it's got that, yeah, that almost like, I associate it with like, lemony, sort of like lemon shandy sort of smell. Cheers, I'm diving in. So, the carbonation, the slight criticism for this beer for me, the carbonation's a little bit too over. It's a bit too much. However, it's not ridiculous. And the beer still tastes great. You've got this lovely malty carameliness that comes through. This breadiness, slight biscuitness to it. But then you've got a quite a distinct lingering bitter hop on this beer. Quite a citrusy note that lingers on your tongue. For something that's quite traditionally British, this is probably a little bit more on the sort of citrusy, sort of hoppy side. What is this coming at? 4.4%. So it's a top session beer. Yeah, it's got that lovely sort of. What's the word I'd describe it as? It's sort of like. It's got a humbleness to it. Maybe humble's not the right word. Maybe it's got this sort of, I don't know, like putting on a comfy pair of slippers sort of feel to it. You know what you're going to get. You know it's quality. However, that citrusy bite is quite lingering. That will put some people off. That would put, especially, I wouldn't prescribe this beer to somebody who drinks a lot of lager. They will find this beer a little bit too bitter, a little bit too citrusy. Because it is there. It's got this malt forwardness that's very sort of comfortable and very sort of like, yeah, I can drink this and just relax and not even think about what I'm drinking. But then there's a hoppiness that claws away. Maybe it's a Fuggles that's in there that's quite got like a slight earthiness to it. Hey, it's a great beer. It's a great beer. This, I'm going to attribute this beer to the A-level class of 2019. One of the best teaching groups I've ever had. Every one of you deserves to do really well. So much talent in that group. So yeah, hopefully you'll all go and have a fantastic art career doing something good. But anyway, here we, let's not digress. This is Black Sheep Pale, born from the pioneering spirit of Paul Theakston, who in 1992 followed his heart and dared to start a new brewery. Brewed in Masham, North Yorkshire, this beer is a culmination of six generations of family brewing expertise, crisp, dry, and bittersweet. It is a little bit sweet, yeah. Be nice if they tell you what hops they use. This is a nice, another nice gardening beer. Sitting in the garden and, you know, doing a few jobs in the garden and drinking this beer. Anyway, what am I going to give this out of 10? It's very similar to a lot of beers I've reviewed. Let's think of something like the Theakston Lightfoot. Similar sort of beer. Theakston Lightfoot, what's the other one I had? The Douche's IPA. Similar sort of beer. It's almost like there's somewhere between 7.5 and 8%, an 8 out of 10. So somewhere between 7.5 and 8 out of 10. It lingers in there somewhere. It's a bit better than a 7.7. Is it 7.8? Do I push it as high as an 8? Maybe because of its tradition. Maybe because of what it stands for. British beer. Maybe because I've never had a bad Black Sheep Ale. I don't know. I'm going to knock it down a little bit because of the carbonation. It's a bit too carbonated. And that gas does come through. You're getting that CO2 flavour that comes through with these bits. If it was bottle conditioned, I think I would be giving this an 8 out of 10. Or even better. But I'm not. I'm going to push it down a little bit. I'm going to give it a 7.8 out of 10. 7.8. I'm going to have thousands of beers on 7.8% because that is where it's at. It's not quite an 8, but it's a really good 7. You know, it's a beer I will definitely come back to on a regular basis. I will come back to it time and time again. Listen, Black Sheep, if you're getting into beers for the first time, don't try it. Don't let it put you off. But don't be surprised. Not all beers are as sharp as this to get you going. You know, not all beers have this sort of lingering citrusiness. There's other beers in this collection I've not tried yet. There's all sorts of stuff. There's Velvo, I don't think I've tried that one before. Oh, I'll tell you what I have tried. Milk Stout, that. If that's as good as when I last drunk it, that is a beautiful beer. So yeah, five more beers to review out of the Black Sheep box set. I hope you can join me. Until next time, I'll see you around.